그래서 저희는 다른 도시에 살고 있는 제가 아는 동생의 국제 커플의 집에 지금 도착했습니다. 이제 여기는 이제 저랑 똑같이 한국 사람인데 캐네디언이랑 결혼한 국제 커플입니다. 세미.
네, 안녕하세요. 저는 세미라고 합니다.
세미는 한국말도 되게 잘해요. 왜 한국말 그렇게 잘하지?
한국에서 2년 동안 살다가 여기 선생님도 만나고.
아, 동생이 선생님이었나?
엄청난 선생님이었죠.
맞아, 세미는 한국에서 한 2년 정도 살았고 한국에서 일도 했고 그래서 거의 원어민처럼 얘기를 합니다.
그리고 바네사 우리 대학교 같이 다녔어. 대학교에서 만났어요.
Yeah, we found out that we both like Big Bang.
Yeah.
And that was before K-pop was popular worldwide.
2015. 15.
Even before 14, 15.
And at some point, Sammy moved to Korea, and then we ended up meeting in Korea at some point, right? That's... I think that was like.
I think 2018 or 19
before COVID.
That's we got closer at that time. Mm.
So at that time we met Sammy and at the same time 동생.
안녕하세요.
하은영 동생. Best friend 홍이에요.
홍? 홍? 네. 아, 홍까지 괜찮은 거야? 네.
여기서도 홍입니다. 안녕하세요.
그 이름이 같네. 갑자기.
So the dog is named Hong. And the papa is named Hong.
So it's the Hong family.
Hong Junior.
Yeah, it's the Hong family.
So Hong Junior, Hong Senior.
Senior.
So Sammy, before moving to Korea, like, did you know anything about Korea before?
I learned their history, I learned the culture, I learned the language before going. And then I went there to study. And I really liked my trip there. I met very awesome friends. I really wanted to work there. And then I got the opportunity. So here I am now.
Did you expect to meet a Korean boyfriend at that time?
No, I was focused on studying.
Ah, 나도. Okay.
I'm all alone.
그러니까 세미는 캐나다에서 태어났잖아, 그지?
아니요, 저 모로코에서 태어났어요.
아, 모로코에서 태어났구나. 그럼 몇 살 때 캐나다 온 거야?
5살.
5살? 아, 그건 몰랐네.
안 물어봤을
거야. 이민자네.
그럼 세미도 이민그랜트?
네.
아, 그러네. But your identity is Canadian.
네.
Okay, okay. 홍은 real Korean.
Real Korean.
한국에서 떠날 생각이 없었어요.
그치, 떠날 생각 없었지.
어쩌다 여기 지금 와야 될지도 모르겠고. 뭐.
진짜 하은 덕분에 갔어요.
아, 그런가?
형도 지분이 있죠. 형 진짜 지분이 있어요. 형 진짜 왕십리에서도 지분이 있어.
그때 한국에서 만났을 때 저 캐나다에 대한 좋은 얘기 했고
다 좋다고 했잖아. 다 좋다고 했잖아.
제가 꼬셨습니다. 캐나다 오라고. 제가 스스로가 심심해가지고 홍을 많이 꼬셨죠. 네, 그리고 진짜 올 줄은 몰랐어요.
나도 올 줄 몰랐어. 나도 올 줄 몰랐어.
4년차?
4년차.
저 같은 경우는 그냥 타이로 캐나다 온 케이스고 홍은 어떻게 보면 이제 와이프 따라 여자친구 따라.
세미가 이렇게
brought. Yeah, okay. So I want to continue where we left off at the cafe. So we were going to bring up about the culture differences between Korean culture and Canadian. Well, Canadian is large, so I'm gonna be more specific. French Canadian culture.
French Canadian.
Quebecois culture. Because there's many cultures within Canada. Well, one thing that I remember when we spent 3 months in Korea and I was living with my parents-in-law, I will always remember that. My mother-in-law, I asked her at some point, oh, do you need help? Like with the dishes. And she was like, 아니야, 아니야, 괜찮아, 괜찮아. My family and my culture, when my mom say no I'm okay means leave her.
No, I'm okay.
Yeah, when mom, do you need help? No, I'm fine, go sit, because that means my mom needs her space in the kitchen. She doesn't need like some people. She's like, she's fine, she's in control, she doesn't expect anything. But apparently Korea somehow no means yes.
Yeah.
Like, I guess she didn't want to say it up front, yes I need help. So you have kind of like have to push, like she's like, nah, 괜찮아. You're like, no, really want to help. And I was like, just, I didn't know that. But apparently, Han told me later that when my mom says no, it means actually yes. It's the thing with intercultural relationships. Like, I think parents, family don't expect the other to know right away what to do. But what's important in the end is to learn. You correct your behavior according to who you are, because it's a learning process. Because you have been used all your life to a certain way and how to behave with parents, and then you have to deconstruct that and have to learn a new way.
Exactly.
Same with Haun. When I first brought him to my parents' place, like when you mentioned earlier, the thing is that my parents offered him alcohol. He was always saying yes. So my mom and her boyfriend like were pushing it, like always offering, because they were like, oh yes, he's good, he's still taking. But I've learned later, apparently, it's rude to say no when someone older or a parent offers you alcohol in Korean culture. So I felt bad. I was like, they didn't know. Yeah, I didn't know either. So.
Yeah, I got super drunk at the time. So in Morocco as well, like if mother-in-law says...
Yeah, no means yes.
No means yes. Oh, okay.
No means yes. It's okay. Like, I'm okay, but that means like...
진짜 가냐,
please
가란다고?
Do something or ask again.
Okay.
Wow. Wow. I was raised in a Moroccan way, but lived and grew up with Canadians. So I think I have both sides of the view, or both sides of the words. Mm.
How long did you like stay in your parents' place?
Until I went to Korea.
Because in Canada, when you get like 19, it's normal to be
independent,
right?
Yeah. No, in general.
Yeah, I'd say as soon as you're a legal adult.
Maybe now the economy is different, but in the past, like kids wanted their independence very early, and like parents also wanted peace at their home.
Back when apartments were affordable.
Yeah, that is true. That is very true.
한국에서는 직장을 구하고 결혼 전까지 어떻게든 옆에 있어야 돼. For saving money.
The same in Morocco.
The main point parents trying to keep their kids like nearby is that it's really hard to save money when it comes to like your like junior position or whatever, right?
So, oh, okay, I see.
But in Canada, it's like when you get 19, like you go out, buy, live your life, right?
That's true.
많이 다르네.
Culture difference.
I think the other one is like, you know, when you're a kid and you go to another friend's home and you sleep and you do like a sleep party, but like in Korea, it's not. What I learned is like you don't do.
Yeah, that's.
I don't do it that much.
Very common.
That like, you know, you go to your friend's house when you're like maybe 14 and then you sleep and then you like you watch TV all night and you sleep.
Like you spend the night at a friend's place, even as a kid.
Yeah, but in like when we grew up, it was the same. Like everyone slept at like other parents' home, other kids' parents' home. But like in Korea, I don't think that's something.
아무래도 남의 집에서 잘라 자게 하는 그 자체가 뭔가 신뢰라고 생각하지 않나?
약간 그런 것도 있지. 그런 것도 있는 것 같고.
We did like pajama parties.
Yeah, me too. Like I did it. I remember one of my friends came and we slept in the same bed and we talked like until like all the night. None of us was sleeping. We just talked.
형 어떤 친구 집에서 잔 적 있어?
난
어렸을 때 많이 난 많이 잔 기억은 없네. 지금 보니까 나도 많이 잔 기억은 없고 친구 집에 또 많이 논 기억은 있는데 집에서 잔 적은 많이 없어.
진짜 없네.
나도 많지 않아. 나도 많지 않아.
생각하면 진짜 그러다. 있을 법한데 없네.
그리고 고등학교 맨날 공부.
Yeah,
근데 물론
right.
공부 말고도 다양한 것들 많이 하긴 했지만 학원을 엄청 다녔지.
But for us, we left school at maybe 3 p.m. And then we're done.
그거는 달라. 아예 달라.
Yeah, so it's like endless. That is indeed opposite side of childhood life.
To be honest, I think from what I've seen in documentaries and according to what a lot of Korean people have told me. To be honest, I think yeah, in Canada we have very good childhoods.
That's true.
I think Korean kids, they are put at, in competition very early. Like, I understand the parents, they just want the best for their kid. They know like it's going to be competitive later for work. So they just, this is for the good of their kids that they're putting a lot of pressure to succeed. Like, the intention is good, but...
I think both sides have pros and cons.
There's no culture that is perfect.
Exactly.
I think in today's world, when a lot of cultures mix, we learn a lot from others. It makes us reflect on our own culture.
I think Sammy's
case,
I think it's gonna be a lot of conflict because like she grew up in Canada, but probably she saw a lot of friends living in like Canadian life. But you still have like a Moroccan culture in your home.
I would say it's more like about the way we eat food. Like we all eat in the same plates. When we're young, it's like you have your plate and then you eat with your friend. And for us, it's waiting for everyone to be seated. Like those kind of 작은 but 좀 한국이랑 되게 비슷한데 비슷한 거 되게 많아. Oh, the only I think the most mistake I made is that I didn't know I have to wait for the elder to start eating. So.
근데 요새는
그래도 뭐 어머니 먹기 전에 아니면 뭐
아니,
아버님
그거를 신경 요새는 많이 쓰나?
근데 모로코에서는 그냥 다 같이 앉기만 하면 되는 거야?
그냥 앉으면 돼.
As long as everybody
as everything is seated, yeah. like you don't need to wait to see who's eating first. At least in my family.
Okay, French Canadian style is whatever. When you have your plate, you can't start.
I've seen you like doing that a lot.
Yeah, and you were like, Vanessa, wait for mom. I'm like, my mom doesn't care.
True, true.
Yeah,
and then you have the 반말 and the 천대말.
Oh, that's right.
For us, everyone is equal in Canada.
Yeah.
What about in Morocco?
Even in Morocco, like we don't have like a 천대말 and 반말. We have like language. Darija, and then we have the formal Arabic, but like in Korea, it's like you have a way to speak to elders, you have a way to speak to work people, you have a way to speak to someone that is younger or older than you, and then it's kind of getting very confusing. So the first time I spoke with my mother-in-law, I used a lot of panmal, and I didn't know.
Okay!
So many times she was saying like...
뭔 말 그랬어? 뭔 말 그랬어? 반말하네. 그때 처음 만났을 때 반말하는 얘기 듣고 아니야, 아니야. 무조건 요를 붙여 요. 요를 붙여.
I remember with your family, but I think they didn't mind because they knew I was limited in Korean. At first, I was like wishing them good night. I was like 잘 자요, but you said you told me you have to say 잘 주무세요.
안녕히 주무세요.
안녕히 주무세요. Now I say it, but I didn't know the only way to say goodnight for me, I learned was
잘 자요. 엄마 아빠한테, 엄마 아빠한테.
But like I said, I'm always open to learn, so my last intention is to offend them.
Yeah, but Korean is not easy.
No.
Like it has a lot of meaning.
So different. Like,
어떻게 오셨어요?
그때 뭐 우리 여행 한국에서 여행을 했는데 그 차를 타다가 길에 잘못 들어서 세미가 내려서 그 사유지에 들어가서 노크를 한 거예요. 근데 그 사람이 나왔어. 여기 어떻게 오셨어요? 이렇게 물어봤는데 차 타고 왔어요. 그래가지고
그 미는 yeah, didn't understand that time.
그 말은 그 말이 아니었는데 여기 왜 왔어? 이 미인데 와인데 타오 이렇게
because like in French and it's just the pronoun difference. Because in English we say you all the time, no matter if you talk to someone older or whatever. But French, we have two types of pronouns. We have the tu, which is the informal you, and we have the vous, which is the super formal.
No.
Depending in some families, they will call their grandparents, they will use vous. And especially my dad's generation, he said vous to his mother. But me, my family is so informal that even my grandparents, I use the informal pronoun with them. But this is the only difference in terms of like being polite or not polite.
그럼 이제 홍한테 질문. 인생에서 외국인의 여자친구 아니면 외국인의 와이프 만날 거라고 생각을 해봤어?
생각도 안 했어.
생각도 안 했어?
진짜 생각도 안 했어. 근데 그 당시에 회사에서 이제 자꾸 영어를 하라고 압박이 들어와서
또 겸사겸사 또 있었네 그런
갔다가, 게 갔다가 그래 이 양 많이 갈 거구나 되게 이쁜
여자
그때 당시에 난 싱글이었고 그러다가 이제 세미가 눈에 들어왔고
그게 어딘 거지?
홍대
홍대 그 언어 교환 이런 분이? 오케이
근데? 나 친구 만들려고 갔어요
근데 세미가
세미는 친구 만들려고
나 친구 만들려고
세미가 도착한 지 한 일주일? 한국 도착한 지? 그때?
일주일도 안 됐어
그때 이제 말을 걸었는데 얘가 한국말로 이렇게 얘기를 하는 거야
아니 그래서. 영어 진짜 못해서 미안해 그때 진짜 영어
아 홍이 영어를 못해서 아 오케이
뭐 지금도 잘하는 건 아니지만 뭐 어쨌든
아 지금 엄청 늘었어
그래
엄청
어쨌든.
잘해 지금 어쨌든 옛날보다
한국말 하니까 오히려 호감이 더 가더라고 조금의 문제는 조금 있지만 그래도 대화가 되고 그게 너무 신기한 거야
그래 맞아 국제 커플의 가장 어려운 점이 언어 충격인데 세미가 오히려 한국말을 해버리니까
당연히 근데 그건 맞아 한국에 있으면 한국말을 해야지
이것도 맞지? 이것도 맞지?
한국말을 했으니까 한국말 해야지
근데 너 영어를 배우러 갔던 거잖아
아 그렇긴 하지 그렇긴 하지
근데 만약 오히려 세미가 한국말을 못했으면 영어만 했으면
안 됐을 가능성이 높아
아 오히려?
오히려 더 높지
언어 장벽 때문에
왜냐면 내가 그 또 노력을 더 안 했을 수도 있어 중간에 포기했을 수도 있어
아
아이, 됐다 못하겠다 이렇게 하고
그만큼 언어 장벽이 큰 거야
그치
그러면 이제 캐나다에 왔잖아 결국엔 한국에서 계속 살다가 한국은 어떻게 보면 단일 민족이고 다른 문화가 없어
그 벽이 있지.
그치, 벽이 확실히 있지.
확실한 벽이
근데
있지.
캐나다 오면서 캐나다는 확실히 다문화 문화가
그치.
너무 너무 많잖아.
너무 신기하지. 한 식당에 가면 뭐 재패니즈도 있고 그치, 인디안도 그치. 있고 프렌치도 있고 미국인도 있고 뭐 다 진짜 다양한 인종 많지.
그 음식에서 봤을 때 그런데 너가 이제 단일 민족의 배경을 갖고 있는 사람으로서 다문화가 가능한 나라로 왔어. 거기에서 뭔가 너가 느꼈던 점이나 아니면 어려웠던 점 아니면 네가 생각했을 때 진정한 캐나다의 문화는 뭘까? 이런 걸 한번 생각해봤었어?
진정한 캐나다의 문화?
난 그게 되게 어려운 질문이라고 생각을 하긴 하거든. 근데 어떻게 보면 우리는 잉글리시 캐네디언을 잘 몰라. 근데 그치. 어떻게 보면 퀘벡 문화를
그치.
그것만 알았던 상황이고 너는 어떻게 보면은 모로코에 대한 컬처도 이제 어떻게 보면은
있지.
그게 이제 네가 느끼게 됐었던 거잖아. 거기에 대해서 네가 뭔가 뭐 어려웠던 점이나 아니면 받아들이기 어려웠던 점 뭐 이런 게 있었어?
일단 한국인으로서 일단 한국인의 그 기준 스탠다드가 높아. 그래서 여기에서 받아들이는 게 어려운 게 되게 많지. 일단은 기본적으로 다 다르잖아. 깨끗하고 뭔가 뭐 빠른 서비스도 있고 그런데 여기는 뭔가 다 느려 터지고 뭐
한국은 뭐 빨리 이런 게 그치. 있잖아 그치?
돈은 돈대로 많이 들고 뭐 했다 하려고 그러면 근데 그거만에 다 이유가 있더라고. 느리면 왜 느리고 돈이 왜 많이 들고 그런 것들이 다 이유가 있어서 처음에는 받아들이기 어려운데 나중에는 좀 이제 그걸 받아들이고 있어. 캐나다라는 나라가 다 이유가 있구나. 그래서 그러다 보니까 개인의 그 생활의 삶의 질이 높아지는 것 같아.
오히려
처음에는
그러니까
서비스들이 합리적이지 않다고 생각할 수 있지만 반대로 여기 이 사회 안에 소셜에 들어가 있으면 이게 합리적인 거고 이게 이유가 있는 거고 뭐 그런 게 다 느껴지더라고. 지금 조금 이제 한 4년차 되니까 조금 그 조금씩 이해가 되는 그런 부분들이.
그럼 세미는 또 오히려 좀 반대일 것 같아. 만약에 이렇게 느릿한 그런 시스템에 적응했다가 갑자기 한국 갔어. 거기 무조건 빨리잖아. 그랬을 때 뭐 어떤 느낌점이 있었어?
너무 헤븐이었어.
헤븐?
So it was hard for me to come back to Canada to the speed of like
right.
going yeah. to the hospital, like having some papers done. Like it takes forever here. We're used to it. So that's why we don't complain. We're used to it. In Korea, it's like I'm surprised every time. And it's a good surprise. It's a happy surprise.
You want to like check up on your body? Like,
yeah.
It's like a day one thing, right?
Yeah, day one you can enter.
Exactly.
Like you just there to ask a question. Like here, if you go, for example, to the dentist, they will say like, okay, you have to take an appointment. You have to call here.
Or family doctor.
And then it takes forever. And then I went to Korea. We went to the dentist and they were ready to take me. And I was like, okay, mentally, I'm not ready. Like, you know, when like you have to take off a tooth and then they're like, you just go to ask an answer on like what's the problem and you're already sitting in the chair like waiting for the dentist.
Let me tell to our Korean audience, you're so lucky with the healthcare system.
Yeah, and it's cheap compared to here.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's so cheap.
Yeah.
Cheap and fast.
Yeah,
and good.
That is.
근데 그거는 한국의 특성인 것 같아. 그
맞아.
medical service 자체는 맞아. 한국이
it's good
진짜 좋은
too.
좋은 거야. 잘 결혼했어.
뭐래?
Still on the wait list for family doctor.
Same.
Yeah.
캐벡도 똑같아?
Family doctor.
Welcome to Canada. And she's in Quebec, I'm in Ontario, so it's countrywide issue.
Yeah, so Canada has to do something about it, but apparently a lot of like things to take care of for self-stay. I don't know like what's gonna be like more priority than health.
So I think we talked about a lot about the cultural difference between Korea, Morocco, Canadian. So, but if you guys want to know more about what other type of cultural difference we may have faced while living in Korea or living with a Korean, well, comment below.
Yeah, hey, all the Gukjik couples out there.
And please subscribe.
And yes, thanks to my good friend and her husband for joining us in this video. It's always good to have other couples like us. We can always like, share our experience.
And au revoir!